Hi, welcome back to my YouTube channel. And if you guys remember, in the last video, I have shown you a screen and asked a question about it, that whether I should use a stateless widget or stateful widget based on our previous understanding. So many of you have written your answers in the comment section below. And if your answer is a stateless widget, then that's correct because nothing is changing on the screen that I showed you. And if your answer is that we should use the stateful widget, then that is not correct because it is just a screen that is showing some buttons and user will click on that and go to the next screen. So that's the answer. And now let's see how to create a new login screen from scratch using Material Design. So follow along this tutorial and upcoming videos to learn how to do it from scratch. So to create a new stateful widget, what I will do is that I will use the shortcut inside the Visual Studio Code that will automatically insert the stateful widget code. By the way, if we want to write, then we can definitely write the whole code, but for time saving, I will use that shortcut. By the way, I'm in the main.dart file, and below the my app class, I am going to insert the stateful widget. So what I will do, I will write stful, and after writing the stful, you can see that an option is appearing that is called flutter stateful widget. And once I click on this, it will insert all the code that I was showing to you previously. And it is asking us to enter the class name. So for example, if I write down login screen here, this will automatically insert that into five places: one here, second here, third here, fourth here, and fifth here. So see the magic. I will write login screen, and it has automatically inserted the code at multiple places. And if I want to go out of this, then I can click anywhere. So for example, if I click here, this thing has automatically inserted the login screen widget here. So again, if you want, you can write the whole code by yourself, but to make things quick and easy for you, I have used this shortcut to create a new stateful widget. So what we can do is that now we can associate this widget to this basically material app widget, and this way now the app will be showing this login screen as the main screen. So this is very simple. What you can do is that you can click, you can go to the home property, and rather than showing a text, what we can do is that we can write the login screen. And if once we write the login screen, you can see that it is suggesting us that do you mean the login screen class that is available below? Yes, we do mean that. And if we write that, now you can see that it automatically inserted the curly braces for us, and it is attached the login screen with this home screen. So if I click on save, or if I try to stop it and run it again, then we will be able to see that our login screen is showing here. But anyway, our build method is showing only a container. So this means that nothing will be showing on this screen. So what is the container? Container is a special widget inside the Flutter framework that is used to add styling to widgets. For example, if you have web development background, then you will be able to understand that this is the alternative of div tag. So in web development, we use the div tag to add styling to different components and elements. So same is the purpose for the container. It has some properties. It can take some, you know, colors, etc., and we can use it for styling. That's it. But again, this is not showing anything. So if I want to show something, let's say if I want to show text, then what I will do is that I will write the text widget here. And once I write the text widget, I can enter the text information. So for example, again, I will say hello world. And now you can see that hello world is showing, but it is hidden somewhere. So this is not showing correctly. So what I will do is that in the next video, I will tell you, we can use something called scaffold. And scaffold, why scaffold?
and what is scaffold. Let's see in the next video.
That's it from this video, and if you have any questions, then make sure to write your query in the comment section below, because I check out each comment and reply to everyone.